So today we are outside because we have a Joe. What is it?
It's an air data computer.
It takes air it computes something. Actually, that's from a B-52, probably.
That's what we suspect.
So we expect a gear and levers computer.
Yes.
Apparently, this computer was first used in the F-86 Sabre, the first American jet fighter introduced in 1949, and which saw heavy use in the Korean War. It was a transonic airplane, which could approach speeds close to Mach 1. At these speeds, a computer is needed to derive accurate speed, altitude, and air density measurements.
So you have the tools. It's a solder seal?
Yeah, I believe so. It should be.
I can't tell you I've done this before. Oh man, that's a piece of cake for you. Oh yeah. Oh! Okay, we'll tell Dave for next time.
And we're in like Flynn.
So it's metal tape with solder underneath?
I think yeah. So. And
the good thing that it should be totally pristine inside, right?
It should be. Hopefully this will just come off.
There are springs and little wheels and man.
Little tubes.
Tubes?
Yeah, over on this side. Probably pressure.
Oh, tubes. I was thinking vacuum tubes. Air tubes.
Sorry, I had no idea you were thinking of vacuum tubes.
And a resolver for turning the thing. So that's an analog computer.
This is awesome.
This little wind-up spring.
Yeah.
The early TI.
It's kind of a weird transistor mounting, the way they're clipped in, and then the leads are just, going into the air. Oh wait, there's a lot of corrosion here.
Can you?
Corrosion or fungus or something.
Ooh, this one developed the whiskers over here.
Tin whiskers?
It looks very fuzzy.
Yeah, or fungi.
I'll taste it.
Look at all these cams and springs. Just, wow, there's a whole mechanical calculator down here. It's the Antikythera mechanism. And another one down here. There are three levels of mechanical thing. Here. And then there are the actuators.
This reminds me of third grade when I had this broken clock that I was trying to fix. And I had no idea what I was doing. But it looked a lot like this with the little tiny gears. And
but this, except this should be coils. Working if we figure it out. So we found out this is a potentiometer. This differential gear thingy is to add a correction. There are little adjustment screws, and it add a subtractal adjustment. So that's a linearization thingy. There's another one here. These are the they are connected to the tube. So this must be the pressure transducers. Ken thinks the magnetics over here may be magnetic amplifiers. We have these are inputs, they're generators, they turn things. There's one more here, there's one more there, and then there are resolvers that read things, and they are. I don't see one on this face.
And we think it's the Bendix MG1 air data computer for the F-86 Sabre jet.
And it says computer central air. Oh, and it tells you which is the static pressure and which is the total pressure, so we know which is which. but it has so many connections. So it is a Bendix, what you say?
MG1.
Normal airplane, you just measure the static pressure on the side of the plane, the dynamic pressure in the front of the plane with a little pitot tube, and you make the difference of them all, and you get your airspeed.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think you want more accuracy if you're, like, you know, dropping bombs and stuff.
All right, so this thing must do better math. Okay.
Wow.
Ready for the reverse engineering?
Yep.
While we send Ken on a reverse engineering adventure, let's take a good look at this marvel of electromechanical engineering. Who needs electronics when gears will do? And to operate our new toy, we'll have to dabble in a new field for us, vintage aircraft instrumentation, and learn a bit about fluid dynamics, which will keep us busy for quite a few upcoming episodes. Thanks, Joe, for donating this to the channel. This will keep us entertained for a while.